In the vast landscape of electronics, inductors may not always grab the spotlight, but they are indispensable. In this video, we'll demystify this vital component. Let's begin at the foundation. Here's a simple wire. This is the simplest form of an inductor. When electric current passes through it, it doesn't remain passive. It produces a magnetic field in response. Now you may ask, why? Why is a magnetic field produced? When electric current flows through a wire, it's essentially a movement of electrons. In the world of electromagnetism, moving electric charges, like our flowing electrons, give rise to a magnetic field around them. This phenomenon is governed by Ampere's law. It tells us that the movement of these charges in the wire creates a circular magnetic field that surrounds the wire. If you've ever heard of the right-hand rule, it's a handy way to visualize this. Point your thumb in the direction of the conventional current, which is opposite to the actual flow of electrons, and the way your fingers naturally curl will show you the direction of the magnetic field around the wire. If you want to learn more about electric current, check out our video on it. Now, the magnetic field generated around the wire isn't just a fancy side effect. It's at the core of how inductors work and find purpose in circuits. So, what is this purpose? What is the basic function of an inductor? Well, it is to resist sudden changes in current. Think of an inductor as being similar to a water wheel in a steady stream. When the water flows consistently, the wheel turns smoothly. However, if you try to suddenly increase the flow of water, the inertia of the wheel resists the immediate change, resisting the sudden rush. Conversely, if you attempt to abruptly halt the water's flow, the wheel doesn't stop instantly. It slows down gradually due to its built-up momentum. In the world of electronics, an inductor is much like our water wheel. When there's a sudden increase in current, the magnetic field generated by the inductor also strengthens, inducing a voltage that opposes this change. Conversely, if the current starts to drop off, the weakening magnetic field induces a voltage that tries to maintain the current level. Now let's summarize what we have covered so far. We have seen how a simple wire, when carrying electric current, not only generates a magnetic field but also inherently opposes rapid changes in that current. This behavior results in the storage of energy within the magnetic field itself. This is, in essence, the basic functionality of an inductor. Many of you might now be wondering, when I think of inductors, I envision coiled structures, not just a single straight wire. What's the story behind that? The truth is, while a straight wire can indeed exhibit inductive properties as we've discussed, in practical applications, the wire is coiled to enhance these properties. Coiling the wire multiplies the magnetic field's effects. Each loop of the coil produces its own magnetic field when current flows through it. When these fields overlap and reinforce each other, the cumulative magnetic field becomes much stronger. This design not only augments the inductor's ability to oppose changes in current, but also increases its energy storage capacity. Additionally, you might have come across inductors that have a core made of materials like iron or ferrite. Why add this core? The answer lies in amplifying the inductor's efficiency. These core materials are magnetic in nature. When used as a core, they serve to concentrate and channel the magnetic field produced by the coil. This intensifies the magnetic field, further boosting the inductor's capacity to resist changes in current and enhancing its energy storage potential. Essentially, these cores optimize the inductor's performance, allowing it to function more effectively in various electronic applications. They play a pivotal role in filters, where they help smooth out voltage or current waveforms. They're essential components in transformers, facilitating the transfer of energy between two or more coils. Furthermore, the property of energy storage in the magnetic field finds application in devices like switch-mode power supplies, where energy is stored in the inductor during one part of the cycle and then released later. This capability, combined with other components, can help convert a DC signal to a different DC voltage or even to an AC signal. In essence, the principles and behaviors we've explored today are foundational to ensuring that many of the electronic devices we use daily operate efficiently and reliably. We trust this video has shed light on the intricate world of inductors. If you've gained new insights today, let us know in the comments. Also, we're always eager to hear what topics you'd like us to tackle next. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button for more enlightening content. Thank you for tuning in.